G'day everyone, I'm Dr. Peter Price of Classroom Professor. Welcome to this week's free math worksheets video. This week we're looking at a fairly easy set of number facts for younger students using the count on and count back one strategy. So this is addition and subtraction revision. So we have these four different sorts of questions that you'll see on the worksheets. Adding one, taking away one, start with one so it's a turnaround fact, and find a difference of one. So I'll just talk about these briefly and just, you know, give some suggestions here. What we want our students to do with this strategy, the count on or count back strategy, is to rely on their familiarity with the sequence of number names. So in other words, having counted since they were very young children from one, two, three, four, five, you know, using Sesame Street's examples or other similar programs, the student should be familiar with the number that comes after, for example, six. If you're counting from six, you could ask students, close your eyes, think of the numbers up to six, don't say anything, what comes after six? You know, that sort of thing. Counting back, same idea. We want the students to think about counting backwards. So they should be familiar with counting forwards and backwards. What comes after nine if we're counting backwards? That sort of idea. Let me just make a point here. We don't want students counting on their fingers, so I would not recommend that you say, look, just show me six fingers and what's one more. The trouble with that is, although it's not a bad idea to think about counting, if they count on their fingers, that can become a habit that is difficult to break, as most habits are. What I would suggest in its place is our friend the 10 frame, which I've talked about in previous videos. So you could... let me quickly put this up here. The students will become familiar with the patterns of the counters in the 10 frame. So if you say, what number is that? They will quickly say that's six. If I put one more, what is it? Now they should be able to recognize it or subitize it without counting, so they could quickly see. So all of these questions can be done that way. 1 plus 7. Again, using a count-on strategy, of course, we don't start from 1 and then count on 7. That defeats the whole purpose of memorizing number facts. But if we start with the 7 and count on 1. So we want students to recognize that if we're only adding 1 or 2, and I wouldn't go any further than that, then we can use a counting strategy. But if it's the other way around, it's still the same number. So there'd need to be some practice in recognizing the turnaround nature of the number facts. The fourth sort is the trickiest. 4 takeaway 3 relies on students knowing that 4 takeaway 1 is 3 or 3 plus 1 is 4. Or basically what we're looking at here is, what's the difference between these two numbers? In the mathematical sense, 4 and 3 are next to each other on the number line. They're next to each other if we show them using counters. There are 4. How many would we have if we took away 3? We're not counting back 3 this time. We're just saying, what's the difference between that number and that number? So using a number line, using a 10 frame, that can easily be shown. So there's various examples on the worksheet. What we really want is for students to see that when the numbers are next to each other and we take the smaller one away from the large one, the answer will be 1. Okay, so I hope that's been helpful. Use the worksheets this week, and I'll talk to you next time.